Although in this lesson we are learning about the addition of mixed units of volume or capacity, the units of length and mass are also added similarly. But in this lesson we will focus on units of volume. We have already learned about the metric units of volume here on the board behind me. 1 kiloliter is equal to 1,000 liters. And I have the abbreviations in parentheses that we use for these measurements. Kiloliter, we say KL for abbreviating it. And for liters, we simply use a lowercase or an uppercase L to indicate liters. And 1 liter then is equal to 100 centiliters, or CL for abbreviation. And 1 centiliter is equal to 10 milliliters, or ML for abbreviation. If you have not learned about some of these units yet, do not worry about it. You'll learn them as you use them more. A mixed unit measurement is where the measurement is taken in more than one unit. For example, if the volume of a water tank is given as 100 liters 20 centiliters, it is a mixed unit measurement because you are measuring the volume of the water in both liters and in centiliters. Let's talk for a minute about why we have some measurements in mixed units. We measure in mixed units because the volume of the water tank is more than 100 liters, but less than 101 liters. It's 100 liters plus 20 centiliters. To find the correct volume, we need to measure it in liters and then in the smaller units of centiliters. Let's look at an example of addition of mixed units. Our example asks us to add 10 liters 90 centiliters plus 2 liters 70 centiliters. As you can see, we are adding mixed measurements together here. We have 2 mixed measurements, liter centiliter plus liter centiliter. So adding mixed unit measurements together is a 2-step process. For step 1, you want to add the like units. You can do this easily by vertically aligning the like units. So we're going to put liter under liter, and we're going to put centiliter under centiliter. So first, we'll start out by lining these up. 10 liters, 90 centiliters, plus 2 liters, 70 centiliters. We add those together, adding like units. So we've got 90 plus 70 is 160 for centiliters. And then 10 plus 2 is 12 for 12 liters. Step 2 then is to look at the result of step 1. So far this is our result of step 1. 12 liters, 160 centiliters. You want to look at your result and see if any of the units can be simplified to a bigger unit. Sometimes you don't have to convert or simplify, but sometimes you have to. It all depends on what you are adding. So as we look at our result, 12 liters, 160 centiliters, we know that 100 centiliters is equal to 1 liter. That 1 liter equals 100 centiliters. So we can see here that in our 160 centiliters, we can break that down to 100 centiliters plus 60 centiliters. So we can rewrite this 160 centiliters as 100 plus 60, and we know that 100 centiliters is equal to 1 liter. 100 centiliters is equal to 1 liter. So we have our 12 liters plus 100 centiliters plus 60 centiliters. We're going to change this 100 centiliters to 1 liter. So we'll have 12 liters plus this 1 liter plus 60 centiliters. And now, again, we can combine our like terms of 12 liters plus 1 liter. 12 liters plus 1 liter is equal to 13 liters, and we have our 60 centiliters. So once we're ready to give our answer of the measurement, we don't need to put the plus sign in between anymore. Just as you can see that here, 10 liters, 90 centiliters, we can write it just all in a row without a plus sign in between it. So we end up then with an answer of, for adding 10 liters, 90 centiliters, plus 2 liters, 70 centiliters, our final answer is 13 liters, 60 centiliters.